Today is February 4th, and it is also a Sunday, which means today is check-in day. We have a pretty busy day. We're going to go do something pretty exciting that I've never really documented before, but I do get them done, hint, quite frequently. I'm going to go do that, but first things first, it is a Sunday. We got to go do our check-ins. So let's go do that, find out how much we weigh, and send our check-in photos to our coach.
All right.
All right, so we weighed in at exactly 195, which is a little bit more than a 2 pound drop. And some people might say that that's too much for a week. I think the beautiful thing about the sport of bodybuilding is that when I send that number and that weight change to my coach, one of three things is gonna happen. He's gonna say, great, keep your food where it is, keep your cardio where it is, you lost weight on it, let's see if you lose weight again. Or he's gonna say, okay, you're still 14 weeks out. You might wanna slow that change a little bit. Let's give you a refeed meal or a cheat meal. Or option number three is he's gonna say, cool, let's kick it up a notch. Let's drop the calories even lower and let's up the cardio. So we'll see what happens. A lot of it though is based off of, and this is what I try to tell people all the time, it is not based off the scale, it is based off of how you look, which is why it's so important, which is why I'm about to do these check-in photos. So a quick little hack that I've kind of discovered is these tripods that you can buy on Amazon. Traditionally, what I've had to do is I've had to set up my phone on the tripod, set it on like a 10-second timer, run back, try to get into my pose and flex and then hold it, and I just don't really do that anymore. Most of them come with like a remote Bluetooth shutter, so I've been using that. That allows me to actually get into my pose properly, not have to worry about scooting through this tiny doorway, avoiding the tripod, and then hitting my pose, not doing it correctly, and then coming back and having to do it again. But with that being said, let's hit check-ins. Cool, so now that check-ins are done, I just have to send these to my coach. But let's talk a little bit about what this video is going to be about. So before we get into the macro topic, which we're going to do, as you can tell from the title of the video today, we're going to be talking about how to calculate your macros. But before we do all of that, we're going to go get a tattoo. Now, if you follow me on Instagram, you might have saw that this week I also came back home with a new car. And so some of you might think that new car, new tattoo, quarter life crisis. No, that is not what it is. So my old car actually wasn't even in my name. It wasn't even my car. It was a car that my parents bought me in 2018 when I was in college. So it was under their name. It was their car. And it has like 170,000 miles on it. It still drove really well, but the value of the car was only like $1,500, and I took it to the shop for an oil change, which was going to cost me $100 anyway. And I kind of told them about some of the electrical problems that I was having with the steering wheel, with the horn not working, and the cruise control not working. And they said to fix those things, which to me is what kind of makes that car useful with good gas mileage, just being able to go pretty far in a practical car. To fix all of those things, it was going to be like $500. And a $500 repair on a $1,500 car, to me, it just kind of seemed like it was time to move on. So I did buy a new car. When we're on our way to the tattoo appointment, I will give you guys a walkthrough of the car. I absolutely love it so much, and it makes me really happy because I've been working really hard this past couple year and a half, and it just seems like things are coming to fruition. So happy guy. But this tattoo that I bought was from the same guy, and I would say 10% of the comments and the DMs that I get on Instagram are about something tattoo related. But the guy that did the phoenix on my leg, a lot of people really like that one. That's kind of the first big one that I ever really got. This guy, he owns a couple tattoo shops. His name is Alan Lott. Put his Instagram in the description in case you guys want to go book with him. But first big tattoo that I got, people really like it. And on Black Friday, he was running a sale where if you paid in full for a day and booked in advance, essentially, you got 50% off the day. So I was like, fuck it, why not? Let's do it. So today I'm going to be getting my first real arm piece because I have just a couple tiny guys on my arms. I've always been kind of afraid to put something on my arm, but I'm getting my entire lower inside of my right forearm done. And I'm not going to reveal exactly what it is yet because I kind of want all of us to go through this journey together, as I have not even seen the design yet. I just gave him inspiration. But we're going to go knock that out. We're going to grab some breakfast, go get our tattoo. It's probably going to take the entire day. But then as soon as we're done, we're going to catch back up where we're going to talk about how to properly calculate your macros. The do's, the don'ts, the myths, the facts, and the science that goes behind all of that, especially in 2024 with so much information but also misinformation out there. So I'll catch you guys in a sec. I bought a new car last week. I posted some pictures of it on Instagram. Thought I'd give you guys a little walkthrough. So here she is. A lot of people for some reason thought I bought it new. I did not buy a new car. New cars are very expensive. She is a beauty. 2021 IS350 F-Sport. Let's check out the inside. I got the red, which is definitely pretty sweet. Honestly, the funny thing is, when I was buying this car, there was pretty much the exact same one at a different dealership with black interior. And when I came, I looked at the black one first. When I came and looked at the red one, I honestly didn't really consider that to be an advantage in my buying process. I kind of just valued them both the same, and I was able to negotiate this red one down to a much better price. But now in hindsight, it does feel super cool to drive a car with the red interior.
I love it. And considering I'm coming from 148 horsepower with an inline four.
Yeah, bro. I went from fucking Nissan Maxima to just this past year I got a.
You have an AMG, right?
Yeah, I got the AMG C43. It's got like the twin turbo V6. Man, that fucker whips.
Yours is blacked out too, isn't it?
Check it out. I love it so much.
Dude, this is gonna be so clean.
You like the placement?
I love it, yeah.
We're about 45 minutes into the actual tattooing, and this is how we're looking. Honestly, nothing hurt too bad. Down towards the wrist, definitely got a little spicy, but at least there's not a ton of detail there. I thought this part near the bend of your arm would be worse. That really wasn't that bad either, so we're gonna finish up here in a sec. Gonna pound some rice cakes first. But yeah, catch you guys in a bit. It is actually 11:40. Took a bit longer than expected, but look at this final product. Oh, check this out. So sweet. I've seen so many tattoos with faces where the face just looks like super fucked up or the nose is flat, but man, look at that face. Super pleased with how that looks.
We're gonna fuck up your little video of my story.
I'm about to put you in this, gotta give the man credit.
What's up, man?
I'm gonna link his Instagram.
Yeah, for sure, dude. Definitely throw that in there.
In the description if
Sacred
you got
Sacred Mandala Studio.
If you want work like this. Only man to see.
Yeah, for sure.
And I've researched lots of people in the Raleigh area. Only person in a 50-mile radius that's touched or done work on my body.
So this is take number two, because this guy did not want to focus on the whiteboard for the first take, so I watched it back. I actually put the SD card in the camera and realized none of it was in focus. So your macronutrients are your fats, your proteins, and your carbs. I feel like once people start to understand, or they've calculated macros for at least some set period of time, they understand why eating fats and eating a bunch of junk is so bad for you. So for reference, proteins are 4 calories per gram. Carbs are also 4 calories per gram. And when you get into fat, fat is 9 calories per gram, so it is more than twice as calorie dense as proteins and carbs. Hence why if you eat a high fat diet, you're probably fat. Now there's a lot of diets out there. There's a lot of fad trends. You have the vegan diet, you have carnivore diet, you have keto diet, you got the paleo diet. Even in all these diets, it's the calories that matter. Calories in versus calories out. If there's only one thing that you take away from this video, it is that the only thing that matters, whether you want to lose weight or you want to gain weight, is calories in versus calories out. If your buddy tells you that they've been trying to lose weight for such a long time and they cleaned up their diet and they really feel like they're in a deficit and they're not losing weight, guess what? They're not in a deficit. There's a lot of trends out there, like intermittent fasting. That's where you don't eat for 16 hours and then you eat for 8 hours. Well, that's not a guarantee to lose weight. That's simply simplifying it by saying, if you only can eat in an 8 hour period, hypothetically, you should eat a little bit less. But if in that 8 hour period you eat 5,000 calories, guess what? You're not gonna lose weight. So let's talk about macros and how I calculate them. So I'm gonna use myself as an example, or right now I'm like 195. So maybe not my current self. Let's use a nice round number, but let's use me from 4 weeks ago. 200 pounds body weight. Body weight equals 200 pounds. All right, so what we're gonna do first is we're gonna find our maintenance calories. So in order to find our maintenance calories, we're gonna multiply our body weight times a multiplier of something between 14 to 17. And that range is gonna come from a variety of factors, and the biggest one is your metabolism. So if you're a kid that grew up and you were always the chubby kid, you're probably gonna multiply your body weight times something lower on this sliding scale, like 14. If you were the kid that grew up and you had the really freak metabolism, could never really put on weight, you were like 130 pounds when you were 18 in high school, then you're probably gonna multiply your body weight times something that's a little bit higher on this scale. For me, I really feel like I'm probably somewhere in the middle, but definitely leaning towards this higher side. So for me, what I would feel comfortable doing is saying that to calculate my maintenance calories, what I need to intake to stay the same weight per day, I would do 200 times 16. So let's see, what does that get us? 3,200 calories. So our maintenance calories equals 3,200. I'm just gonna assume that if you're watching this video, the majority of what you're looking for is weight loss. So if this is our 3,200 maintenance calories, this is without exercise, by the way. This is just if I was to go on about my day, do my normal job, walk the dogs, X, Y, and Z, but not work out. This is what I would need to eat in order to stay the same weight. Now, simple science tells us that in a pound of fat, there are 3,500 calories. 3,500 divides nicely by 7 days a week, doesn't it? So if we're looking to lose a pound of body weight, pound of body fat per week, we're gonna divide 3,500 by 7. So we're gonna need to be in a 500 calorie deficit per day. So if we're cutting, we wanna lose a pound a week, we're gonna take our maintenance calories and subtract 500 from it. And that number right there, that's gonna give us our new calories per day. This is our golden number. At 200 pounds, if we wanna lose 1 pound of body fat per week. Now, 1 pound doesn't seem like a lot to you, But over the course of a month, you're gonna lose 4 pounds. Over the course of 4 months, you're gonna lose 16 pounds. And again, this is without exercise. So let's say you put yourself, just nutrition alone, in a 500 calorie deficit per day. If you also work out every single day, whether it be weightlifting, running, or any of that stuff, and you also burn another 500 calories, that's where it really starts to compound. To get into macros, our three macros, we've got our proteins, we've got our carbs, and we've got our fats. If you watch my last YouTube video where I talk about how to set up a killer diet and kind of the steps that you need to take to transition yourself from overly processed foods into a diet where your digestion is optimized and your body can actually use everything that it intakes. A lot of people say that for every pound of body weight that you have, you need to be eating a gram of protein. I'm kind of different. I think especially if you're in a deficit and you're natural and you want to hold on to your muscle, you really need to be eating 1.25 grams of protein for every pound of body weight that you have. So taking myself again as an example, we've got 200 pounds here, which is our body weight. I'm just gonna write body weight actually. Our body weight times 1.25 equals 250, and this is 250 grams of protein. This is what you want to be aiming for every single day. While we're here, let's quickly calculate how much that is in calories. So since we know protein is 4 calories per gram, we now know that from protein you're going to be getting 1,000 calories per day, and that's using up this 2,700 calorie per day total that you need. So in carbs and fats, you only have 1,700 calories left. Now, moving on, the next number or the next macro that I do is fat. So fat, in my opinion, is something that we should always aim to keep lower. And I like to keep carbs higher because carbs make you feel good. Carbs give you really good pumps in the gym. And carbs can actually be used by your body. And especially if you take this macro example that we're doing right now and do it for bulking. So, you know, maintenance calories, instead of minus 500, you do like plus 500. And you're bulking on, let's say, 3,700 calories a day. We do want to keep the fats lower because that's when, if you do a multiplier, so for me, I like to do a body weight times 0.35. If you do a number like 0.4 or like 0.5, a lot of people say you do your fats and your carbs based on what you like to eat more. I'm always like, keep your fats as low as possible, especially if you start calculating your macros to bulk, your body weight keeps going up and your multiplier is like 0.4, the fats are just gonna be at a number that you don't really need. Like realistically, you never really need to be eating like 100 grams of fat. So if we take that calculation, our body weight 200 times 0.35, we're gonna get the amount that we should be eating in fats in grams per day. So 200 times 0.35 gets us 70 grams of fat per day. Now, like we said earlier, fat is very potent in calories. So instead of multiplying this 70 number times 4 to find the amount of calories from fat that we're getting per day, we're going to multiply it by 9. So 70 times 9 is going to get us 630 calories per day that we're intaking from our fats if we're eating 70 grams of fat. Now from here, just simple math, our target calories that we want per day, 2,700, we're going to subtract our protein calories, so let me write pcal, and then we're also going to subtract our fat calories, our fcals, and from there we're going to get 1,070 calories. Now if you want to find that in grams, you guys already know what to do. Carbs have 4 calories per gram. So we're gonna divide that number by 4. and we get 267.5 grams. That is the amount in carbs that we are aiming to eat every single day. So these three numbers right here, 250, 267.5, and 70, those are our macros. If on nutrition alone, we're looking to lose weight, if we're 200 pounds and we're looking to lose a pound of body fat per week, these are the numbers that we're aiming to hit. Weight loss can be a very stubborn thing. A lot of times when people start calculating their macros, that's also the same time that they start cleaning up their diet. What happens is they're gonna lose the first 5 to 10 pounds really, really quickly. And then after that, they might plateau a little bit. They might actually go up a little bit as they gain some muscle. So weight loss is kind of, it's very stubborn. It's definitely not straight linear, but it's more of like a trend. You want your trend to be going in the right direction, whether you're cutting or you're bulking. So if you do end up picking up a scale, a food scale, and weighing out your food and tracking your macros like this, this is the most scientific way to pretty much guarantee that over the long run, you will lose weight. What I do is as you start losing weight, so let's say you start at 200 pounds, you do these macros over the course of 2 weeks, you're 198 now. Good, you're right on schedule. You need to recalculate all these numbers with a new body weight of 198 pounds. Now, I think this is the best, most scientific, most balanced way to lose weight or to gain weight in 2024 without having to do some crazy diet. And some of these diets can also be really expensive. But if you try this out, please let me know. The last video I shared, guy got a lot of direct messages and texts saying that it was really helpful for them. So if you try this out, message me on Instagram. I'll link that in the bio. I'm also gonna link a food scale in the bio if you need something or you don't have a food scale to weigh out all your food. I'll link one in the bio. I think it's like 10 bucks. The Amazon Basic one is awesome. I literally have like three of them sitting in the house behind me. But if you try this, let me know. Please like, comment, and subscribe. The workout content is coming back. I think the next video that I do is gonna be either a back day or a chest day because my upper body days have been so good recently. And my body is changing a lot. I'm starting to see striations. So please like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you wanna see more of, and I'll catch you in the next one.